Lord, everybody, and welcome to Nite Line. I am your host for the evening. I am Annie T. Broughton, and I tell you what, I am so happy and delighted to be in your homes on tonight. We're going to have amazing time tonight on Nite Line. Oh, my goodness, the Holy Spirit is already here. We had prayer before we came on the air, and I am so glad that we did because we want the Holy Ghost to have his way out here tonight in the name of Jesus. We have some amazing guests with us tonight. We have Pastor Jermaine Putman from Bread from Heaven, Apostle David Holloway from Open Door Ministries, Pastor Samuel Rivera from Heartland Ministry, Pastor James Goldsmith, Place of Hope Community Outreach, and our gospel recording artist that's going to be singing for us tonight is none other than Rob Williams. Amen. He was out here with us before, and we had to have this young man back with us. Oh, my goodness. You need to call somebody and tell them to tune in to Nite Line tonight. Call somebody. Tweet. You know how we tweet now, send messages and all these different things, all these different technologies we have. Tell somebody that we're on Nite Line tonight and how God is going to be moving. We're going to be talking about the power of prayer tonight, the power of prayer. And I do have a scripture that I want to read for your hearing. It's lifted from James 5 and 17. It says, Elias was a man subject to like passions as we are, and he prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. That was James 5 and 17. You know, the Bible teaches us that man should always pray and not cease from praying. Oh, my goodness. Tonight, I'm believing that souls are going to be saved, hearts are going to be healed, minds are going to be regulated, where the enemy has been trying to come against you and take your mind and steal your peace. How many know through prayer? Somebody say prayer. Come on, somebody home, say prayer. Amen. Prayer changes things because we know that God is just a prayer and an answer away. Jeremiah 33:3 says, call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not of. Oh, my goodness. We're going to have a time tonight. If you are sick in the hospital, come on. I want you to know that through prayer, God is your healing. He's going to touch and heal your body. I don't care what the doctor said. God is going to touch and heal your body on tonight. I believe that. I'm calling it forth in Jesus' name. We're getting ready to go to Rob Williams singing Old School Medley. Amen. Praise God.
I'm a soldier
in the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier
in the army.
I'm a soldier
in the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier
in the army.
Got my war clothes on
in the army of the Lord.
Got my war clothes on. If I die, let me die.
In the army of the Lord.
If I die, let me die.
In the army.
If I die, let me die.
In the army of the Lord.
If I die, let me die.
In the army.
Cause I'm a soldier.
In the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier.
In the army.
I'm a soldier.
In the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier.
In the army.
Got my war clothes on.
In the army.
There's a storm out on the ocean, and it's moving, it's blowing.
If those storms
hey, it will surely drift away. Come on, y'all. Storm out on the ocean, and it's moving, it's blowing. If your soul not anchored in Jesus, it will surely drift away. Come on, y'all. Drift away,
drift away,
Lord.
It will surely
drift away.
If your soul
not anchored in Jesus, it will
surely drift away.
Listen, I want to live so God can use me.
Everybody, praise the Lord, everybody. Well, that was Rob Williams. Oh, my God. He has set the tone for tonight. I'm telling you, we're going to have a Holy Ghost good time out here on Nightline tonight. And you don't want to miss a minute nor a second of what God is going to speak to us tonight. Well, again, I have some powerful men of God with me on Nightline tonight. Oh, Jesus. They are pastors, they are ministers, they walk in the fivefold ministry gift, they are prophets, they're teachers, evangelists. I'm telling you, God is going to speak to somebody's heart tonight. And so I'm going to just take a few minutes to introduce again these great men of God. We have sitting right next to me, Pastor Jermaine Putman from Bread from Heaven. Thank you, Pastor, for being with us tonight on Nightline.
Thank you for having me.
Amen. Praise God. And Apostle David Holloway. Woo! From Open Door Ministry.
Amen.
God bless you, Apostle.
God bless you.
Amen. Praise God. And then we have Pastor James Goldsmith from Place of Hope Community Center. God bless you, Pastor James.
God bless you.
Amen. Praise God. And then on the end, oh my God, the powerhouse preacher.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Pastor Samuel Rivera from Heartland Ministry.
Amen.
God bless
praise
you. Thank you for being with us tonight.
Good to be here. It's
amen. Praise God. Well, you know, we're going to be talking about the power of prayer.
Amen.
Amen. And I know that you pastors, y'all already know about that.
Yes.
What the power, what God can do through prayer.
Amen.
But we want somebody may not know what the power of prayer would do. So we want you to tell them what the power of prayer will do. Amen.
Amen.
So Pastor Putman, what is prayer tonight?
Tonight, prayer is communication with God.
Amen.
And in prayer will change any situation.
Yes.
And it will also change people. We try so much to try to change people, but all we got to do is begin to pray for them.
Just
and
pray
trust
for
God.
Them. Yes.
Trust God to move on their behalf.
Mm-hmm.
Prayer is a powerful thing.
Yes.
Amen.
I can't go a day without it.
Can't go a day without it. Can't go a day without it. Not a minute or a second. Amen. Praise God. Pastor Apostle Holloway, what is prayer? Tell us tonight. What do you think prayer is? I thank God for what Pastor Putman said. Add your little you know, tell us what prayer is.
I think prayer is just simply just talking to God, having a conversation with your Heavenly Father. Mm-hmm. You know, prayer is paramount, first and foremost, you know, in my life, and it should be in the life of everybody, every born-again believer.
That's right. Yes.
Prayer is vital to our spiritual walk, spiritual growth. Just spending time with God, talking to God, mm-hmm. is key. That's what prayer is to me.
Amen.
Amen.
Pastor James, why is prayer so powerful, though?
Prayer is so powerful because it comes from God.
Mm. Amen.
I mean, it comes from God. You know, Scripture awesome. In the Bible talks about prayer is the key to the kingdom,
mm-hmm.
and faith unlocks the door.
Come on now.
You know, so, I mean, without prayer, we ain't going nowhere and we ain't going right. to do too much.
Amen. There you go.
And, that's how if we pray, that's how we get God to move for
yes.
us. You know, our communication with Him, you know.
Yes.
And that's how God moves. Mm-hmm. Talking
Amen.
To Him.
Amen.
Talking
Amen.
To Him. So.
Yeah, praise God. Pastor Samuel, the power of prayer means to you? What does it mean to you?
Prayer is communication with God, and it links us to God. And it bonds us to God. And then when we start praying, because we have access to heaven, you know, there's a lot of people running around trying to find free Wi-Fi. Mm-hmm. And Christians have free Wi-Fi all day long.
Trying to find a wife.
Free Wi-Fi.
Okay.
Not wifey. But prayer is it's like having your own cellular network, right,
Woo,
fellas?
Come on.
It gives you access to the throne of grace,
yes,
and
yes.
And it connects with God
Amen.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And the way that God guards His Word, He also guards prayer.
Amen.
There you go. There you go.
Amen.
There you go. Amen. I told y'all, I said, you know, before we came on the air, I said, you know, I know y'all some powerhouse preachers. And, all that anointing is flowing. I don't know if that seat going to be able to hold all that.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. Praise God. But why is it necessary to have prayer in our walk with God, Pastor Putman?
There's no other way you can walk
okay.
without prayer.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Because prayer is communication. You let the Father know what you need and what you expecting from Him on His promises, and not only that, but things that we can't even handle. We just let the Father know, and the Father begin to work it out for us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The Holy Spirit just have His way with us, and when we learn to lean and depend on the Holy Spirit,
mm-hmm.
the Holy Spirit guides us and helps us to be able to even have that walk with God.
Wow, and praise God.
It's a necessity.
Amen.
Just
Amen.
Like the air we breathe.
Yeah.
You got
Amen.
To have prayer.
There you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Amen. Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Apostle, what were you doing when you first came in your encounter with God, when you first started your prayer life with God?
When I first started my prayer life with God, I fell in love with God.
Uh-huh.
I fell in love Amen. With prayer. See, prayer to me is not a religion. Prayer is a way
That's
of life
right.
to me.
That's right.
You know, prayer is my talking to, you know, I have to stop. See, prayer is powerful in the spirit realm.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know, prayer moves things in the spirit realm. And when you pray, amen, you take authority, you get strength, you get power. God gives you wisdom. He gives you understanding. That's why prayer is so powerful. Because everything you need, God can release it to you through prayer.
That's right.
Wow.
Amen. Everything you need, God will give you through prayer.
Yes,
she will. Is there a certain way that we need to pray in order to get in contact with God, Pastor James?
Yeah, it is. And you know, that's very important, you know, to have a time,
mm-hmm.
you know, and get up a quiet place.
Amen.
You
okay.
know, and you know, the Bible talks about Jesus, you know, got up, you know, early in the morning,
mm-hmm.
you know, and before it was even daylight. While
wow,
it was still
that
dark.
That counts some of us out.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
But
Go ahead.
You know, while it was still dark, you know,
yeah.
and find a solitary place to go and pray, you know, and talk to the Father. You know, and we should do the same thing, you know,
That's
because
right.
it makes a difference. You know, to find a place, you know, his was early in the morning. Yours might be in the evening, you know, or something. But it's important, you know, to find your place
mm-hmm.
and, you know, and find your thing and how that you do it that works best for you.
Yes.
And I think that's what makes it powerful. Ooh, you know, what makes what works for you is makes it it's powerful.
Yes.
And like Jesus, early in the morning.
Early in the morning.
You know, some people pray late in the evening. You know, I was a night owl myself. You know? I would like to pray late at night, you know. And so, but I know that when you do that, when you get your specific time and it makes a difference.
Yes.
And it makes it powerful when you get in that right place.
Well, it does make it possible when you get in that right place. Go into your prayer closet and just get before the Lord and just pray and just call on the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Is there power in the name of Jesus, Pastor?
There's power in the name of Jesus, and the devil trembles when he hears the name of
Jesus.
There is no other name that's greater than the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
There's power. It's loaded.
That's right. Amen.
It's loaded.
So will you consider prayer as a secret weapon?
Prayer is a devastating power that will destroy anything that Satan has raised up.
Amen.
And prayer, when it is handled right, because in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14, it says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray,
there
then he will hear from heaven.
There you
So when you humble yourself in the mighty presence of God, the hordes of hell cannot prevail against you.
Come on.
That's right.
Amen.
That's
right. I feel like shouting right now.
There you go. That's what I want y'all to do is shout right now. Amen. We want to be like Sean Johnson. Hold my mule. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Because the word of God said we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. What are we wrestling against, Pastor?
Principalities and the spirit. Things that we can't even control. But through prayer, we can control it.
Amen.
See, we look at people, and when they do things, we want to take it personal because we're in the natural.
Okay.
But when you see the things through the spiritual realm, then you understand it's not that person that God created. It's that spirit or something that the devil has tried to attach himself to cause you to stumble and fall, to keep you from reaching what God has for you. But when you understand what God has for you and you're in the spiritual realm, you begin to see things with your spiritual eyes. In Romans, Paul talks about having eyes in your heart. Them your spiritual eyes.
Come on
then
now.
Then you can still love your enemy when they do you wrong.
Go deep.
And when you love your enemies, when they do wrong to you, you're showing and displaying Christ that lives on the inside of you. But now it takes the Holy Spirit to do this. You can't do it without the Holy Spirit. I'm just going to keep it real with you. I can't do it without the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And so I ask the Lord to allow the Holy Spirit to just have his way with me and lead and guide me. Even when people come up or situations come up, I know it's the enemy trying to trip me, trying to keep me from the promise of God, trying to get me out of the will that I may miss my blessing.
Come on.
But the devil is a lie.
Come on.
I promise you, he's a lie. God has me and gonna keep me.
Amen.
And because he keeps me, I'm going to steadfast in his word and in his love. And I'm going to pray without ceasing.
Yeah, the word of God said, be ye steadfast.
Yes, ma'am.
Unmovable, always.
Amen.
Abounding in the work of the Lord.
That's right.
And as much as we know that our labor
is not in vain.
Amen. Praise God. What is praying in the spirit, Apostle?
Praying in the spirit is allowing the Holy Spirit to pray through you. When a person prays in the spirit, they're praying in line with the perfect will of God. Praying in the spirit is just being energized by the spirit of God. In the book of Jude, it talks about building up yourselves on your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Ghost. So that's why it's so very important for us to be filled with the Holy Ghost. You know,
there
when you get before God and you begin to pray, God gives you a filling. He refills you.
Yes.
He strengthens you for the
Come
day.
On, talk about
you
it.
Know, when you go into your prayer closet, like Pastor James was saying, you know, early in the morning, you go to your prayer closet, that's your filling station. So that's where we go to get filled up.
Yes.
You know, when you start off early in the morning, your tank might be on empty. But after you come out your prayer closet, your tank is on full and you're ready to face the day. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. And as a pastor, we need to know how to pray. Right, Pastor James?
Yeah, we definitely need to know how to pray and to have power, you know, with our prayer. You know, the Bible talks about, you know, the effectual verbal prayer of a righteous man availeth much.
Okay.
I mean, when you go in your kitchen, you know, and you put something on the stove, you know, you don't turn on the eye, you know, and get it hot. It ain't cooking nothing. I'm telling you
not. Oh, my God.
Nothing going to get done.
What?
But when you put some heat behind it, yeah, I guarantee you those eggs will get done. Those collard greens will get done. You put the heat behind it. And so that's what we have to do, especially as pastors. I mean, we got to be fired up and put the heat behind our prayer.
Amen. That's true. We got to put the heat behind it.
Amen.
Wow. Can't do too much cooking on a cold stove,
Can't do no cooking on a cold stove.
No cooking.
No cooking at all.
Amen.
Look at Pastor Sam down there shaking his head.
Well, he fired me up. He's getting me riled up here. I feel the anointing flowing.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Pray. Amen. Did you want to say something? Piggyback off what he said?
Piggybacking off of what he said. Psalm 91 says, to dwell in the secret place of the Most High God, you will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So if we find a quiet place with God and we go in there humble and we ask the Lord to help us in our infirmities.
Yes.
The word of God says that He will cover us with His feathers. He will cover us with His feathers.
God.
Now, we know that's metaphoric speak. You know,
Because
God doesn't have feathers.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. If the word of God said He will cover you with His feathers, is that He's protecting you against the wicked one.
Amen.
Come
and
on.
The wiles and wicked schemes of the dark one.
Yes.
And when we come, when we serve the Lord, we are engaging Him in prayer, but we are engaging the realm, the dark realm, in warfare.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And a Christian that is not praying is a dead Christian.
Oh, my God.
Ooh, my
because
God, my God.
Prayer is God's currency to results. It produces
Amen.
Results. I am the byproduct. I wasn't always saved and born again and filled with the Holy Spirit. I am the byproduct of prayer. My salvation was produced because there was a grandmother and a mother praying for my salvation.
Yes,
and prayer produced results.
Ooh, my God, my God.
Yes.
Can I tell somebody tonight, you need to call somebody and tune in. Amen. Tell them to tune in to Nightline tonight. We're talking about the power of prayer. Amen. Praise God. You may go to a song by Rod Williams, Calvary. To God be all the glory.
Amen.
Amen.
God brought you out. All the wrong that we've done, He took it to the cross and paid out the debt for our sins. Listen.
Calvary, oh, it is the place where Jesus died for me. Calvary, ooh, He sacrificed His life so that I might be free. Though He hung, bled, and died, there's a chance for you and I to be redeemed. All because of Calvary. Calvary. Talking about Calvary. That's the place where He hung, bled, and died for you and for me. Listen. Calvary is where
died on the cross for my sins. What kind of man is this to lay down his life for a friend? Calvary is where my soul can be set free, and whom the Son set free is free indeed. Talking about when I talk about Calvary. Hallelujah. That's the place where he hung, bled, and died for you and for me. Oh, good God Almighty. Some call it Golgotha's Hill. Calvary's Hill. And even though he don't deserve it, he did it anyway. If David Allen was here, he'd say it like this. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. Can I get a witness? That's love. Oh, yes, it is. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. Oh, that's love. Help me sing it.
Jesus went,
yes, he did.
Calvary.
I know he did.
Jesus went,
yes, he did.
Calvary.
And that's love.
Love.
I really know.
That's love.
I, Jesus went to Calvary. And he did it all
Jesus
for you and me.
Calvary.
I know that's love. Yes, it is. Hey, love. Jesus went to Calvary and he paid the debt for you and me. That's love. Hallelujah, Jesus. I know. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, that was Rod Williams singing Calvary. And I tell you, Jesus did go to Calvary for us to save a wretch like you and me. That's Amen. Love. Amen. And thinking about going to Calvary, we had a salvation report called Ooh. In tonight.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Somebody gave their heart to the Lord on Amen. Tonight. And we Great. Want you to know Amen. We are so Amen. Happy
Amen.
And thankful that you are now a part of the body of Christ in the name of
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. We had a praise report also. It says Angela was here from carcinoma. She wanted to give God praise for her healing. God bless
Amen.
You. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. We are so happy for you. Yes. And that's what we're talking about tonight. It's the power of prayer
Amen.
And what prayer will do. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Continue to call in. We got some awesome prayer partners out here tonight. And we are here just for you to talk with you, to pray with you, to encourage you in your walk
yes.
with God. Amen. If you need your soul saved, call in. We got somebody to lead you to Christ tonight.
Yes.
In
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Well, I'm getting ready to go back to these awesome, powerful pastors.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the
Hallelujah.
Lord. They've been kind of holding back. Mama said, don't let go and let God.
Amen.
Amen. Have
Amen.
His way. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We're still
Amen.
Talking about the power of prayer and what prayer would do. So that's a salvation report.
Amen.
Just a brother, sister came to the Lord tonight.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
How do you feel about that? Just knowing that somebody's getting saved tonight, Pastor and Sam.
That, you know, I was telling my wife on the way here, you know, we need a hunger. And we need a burden for lost souls, because a lot of times we can get very dull. And so when I get a praise report that somebody just gave their life to the Lord tonight, it ministers to me because it's God answering that prayer.
Ooh, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah, because that was somebody's son, somebody's daughter, somebody's
Amen.
Mother,
That's
somebody's
right.
father.
That's right.
We
true.
Don't know who it was. It was a soul from kept from dying and going to
yes,
hell. Amen.
Right.
Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
So, Apostle, talk to us again about what prayer would do in your life and how God would change you if you give your heart to Christ.
Amen. Prayer is very vital. Prayer is very vital. And when you pray, it changes things. Prayer changes things. Yeah. And you know what? And as we was going to talk, I guess you was going to talk about the prayer of intercession, standing in the gap for people.
Yeah, come on, Pastor.
You know, you can have a situation that looks dire, that looks like there's no way out, looks helpless. Yes. But if you stay in there and you begin to pray and hold on to the horns of the altar, God will turn. I don't care. There's nothing too hard for God.
Come on, say that again.
There is absolutely nothing too hard for God. Mm-hmm. And you might be facing a crisis. You might be facing something right now that's unsurmountable. It looked like, you know, your back is up against the wall. You got an issue that nobody can solve.
Hallelujah.
If you stand in there and you stand on the horns of the altar, God is able to turn that situation around and turn it into your favor. But you cannot give up on prayer.
Amen.
Prayer is powerful. Prayer is powerful. And prayer still works. Prayer still works.
I wonder why is that? See, like that's the last result. We do everything else but pray, and then after a while we can't find anything else. So okay, we might as well pray. Why people do that, Pastor?
I wonder the same question because, I mean, why not try God first?
Come on.
Yes.
But we so quick to call that friend or so-called friend, and that same one don't want to see you get higher, or the one that's going to tell your problems instead of encourage you.
Yeah.
But I just want to tell somebody, whatever you're going through tonight,
yes,
my God, your God bigger than any situation.
Wow. Yes.
Bigger than any HIV, any cancer.
What about drugs?
Drugs,
alcohol,
suicide, alcohol,
depression.
Everything. My God is bigger than anything.
Amen.
Yes. Any situation He can bring you through.
Amen.
Pastor James, is there anything too hard for God?
Nothing's too hard for God to do.
Amen.
Nothing at all. He, the greatest.
Yes.
He, you can look at his creation.
Yes.
And know that it's nothing too hard for God to do.
Yes.
I mean, he put the stars in the sky.
Come on now.
I mean, he made the ocean. He put all the fish and all of the insects, some of the insects that we don't like. You know, get on us sometimes.
Like mosquitoes.
Like mosquitoes and all those different things. And from this, when we look around us and look at nature, we can see
that it's
nothing too hard for God to do. If he did
God.
All of this, your little problem is nothing with God.
Yes.
And it's nothing too hard for him. And that's why we should go to him and not be afraid to go to him. I think sometimes that the reason why people don't, and they go to their friends or go somewhere else either before they go to God, I feel like they feel like they ain't in a place.
Okay.
You know? Yeah. Maybe they hadn't been praying and they feel like that God won't hear them.
Okay.
But I believe that if we go to God and he see our heart
and
humble ourselves, you know, I believe that God will.
Yes.
Hear our prayer
when we
humble ourselves before Him.
Yes.
Even though we hadn't been praying and hadn't been in the place, but if we go then and start then, God will hear that prayer.
God will hear our prayers.
God will hear our prayers.
Yeah, because He said the fervent prayers
of
a righteous man availeth
much.
Amen. Praise God. So no matter where you are,
that's right.
Can you be riding down the road in your car and God still hear you?
Yes, He can.
Can you be on your job and God still
hear you?
Yes,
God always
hears you. All the time.
Talk about that, Pastor.
All the time. I'm praying through the halls of where I work.
Amen.
All the time. And you're moving target because I'm a witness to you, and I'm going to share Christ with you if I see you. If I catch you in the elevator, you're trapped. So the reality is, the Bible says in James chapter 5, verse 14, that if we pray and we bring them to the elders of the church, they anoint them. Earlier when you were talking, brother, it reminded me of the song that Andre Crouch sang where it says, I've had many tears and sorrows.
Yes.
I've had questions for tomorrow. There were times I didn't know right from wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But in every situation, God gave me blessed consolation and let my trials come to only make me strong. Well, the people that don't pray to God and go to their friends, they don't really know a whole lot about God. Because if they really had a relationship with God, they would surrender to a place of prayer, and God would unleash a wonderful blessing over their lives and change everything.
Amen.
I am the byproduct of somebody's prayer, and I said it earlier, that I am born again, saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
And my picture is in the devil's post office. That's why I'm sitting there like this.
So they're like, what now?
My picture's in the devil's...
No, how was that look?
See, we got to take, we prayer.
Amen. Come on now.
Prayer is Jesus' way. Wow. Giving us victory, right?
Amen.
I have had situations. Listen, I pray for a lot of people. I don't know if the camera's on me or not, but I pray for a lot of people. And you know what? It's sad when Christians are in depression.
Amen.
There's a lot of demonic depression going on right now
in the world. Yeah. Right.
Most Christians are suffering some kind of depression. And in the name of Jesus, I take authority over that chain around your neck. Yes. In the name of Jesus, I pronounce God's word, his power. In the name of Jesus over your depression, anxiety, and oppression. In Jesus' precious name, I pray for you. I don't know who you are.
Yes.
You may have just turned the TV on.
Yes.
But I'm telling you right now, there is power in prayer. And if you surrender your life to Jesus Christ, he will break those chains off your back.
Yes, he will.
Yes, he will.
A free man and a free woman.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I couldn't help myself. Yes. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Apostle, if Amen.
I... Hold it. Go ahead, Pastor. What you about to say?
If I might say something.
Yes, go ahead.
We were talking about why people go to their friends and go to all of these other resources before they go to God.
Yeah.
That's because the devil don't want you to go to God first.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He knows that when you start tapping into the heavenly realm, God has a mandate and God has got a covenant with you that he's got to answer your prayers.
Yes.
So the devil try to take your mind off of what God and put your mind on people who cannot help you and places and resources that cannot help you. And that's one of the things I want to say. Another thing, in the opening question, you said, how does prayer change your life? Mm. When you pray to God, God will teach you how to live for him. God teaches you how to obey him.
Yes, he will.
You know, the more I stay in the presence of God, the more God changes my life. The more God transforms my mind. You see, when you pray as a believer, God gives you the wisdom, the understanding, and the knowledge how to fulfill his will and purpose.
Yes.
So prayer and a constant life of prayer has totally changed and revolutionized my life.
Amen.
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 Come
on. Amen. Praise God. You got something you want to say, Pastor?
Yes, I just want to encourage someone that, you know, if God created the heavens and the earth, if he created you and named you and breathed his breath, his spirit into you, why not he can't do anything for you?
Yes.
Right. Mm-hmm. Wow.
I just want somebody to begin to think about that. Nothing is too hard for God. And if God created you, he didn't create you to suffer.
Mm-mm.
He created you to live and have life more abundantly. And if you trust him with all your heart, and try your very best to humble yourself and be up under his submission, God will do anything for you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Anything. And when you're talking about abundant life, see in John 10:10, it said a thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, but I came. That you might have life and have it more abundant.
Amen.
Pastor James, what is abundant life in God?
Oh, my God.
Well, abundant life is God is having what you need. You know? And you ain't wanting for nothing.
Yes. Overflow.
You know, overflow.
I mean, it's just an overflow. Running out and then running on somebody else. So don't stand too close to me.
You'll get some of this. Like David said, your cut running over.
Right.
Yeah.
You'll get some of this if you stand close to me, you know. And that's how we need to be. And when we are around people, we need to let it overflow so it overflow on somebody else, you know.
Yeah.
So
it can get them,
change their life, you know, so they won't be like they used to be, you know.
Yeah.
And be a new person, you know. And that's what it's all about, you know. Being around people in our lives, changing other people. Because the Bible said we are salt of the earth.
Yes,
you know,
we are.
We're supposed to be the light. So when our lives be what they're supposed to be, when we get around somebody else, they got to change. It's like God coming into our presence.
Wow.
You know, when God come into our presence, you know, we're not the same anymore. Things
are
changed.
That's right. That's a new creature.
So, I mean, it's just that power. Amen. You know, that power. So.
The power of prayer, the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Yes. Praise God. So is it okay for us to be able to pray for somebody else when they're going through something?
Amen.
Yes. Come on, Pastor. Tell me about that real quick.
Because, see, when we can't even pray for ourselves, the Holy Spirit prays for us. And see, just like Pastor down here, he said earlier that he's a byproduct. Somebody was praying for me back when I was in the club.
Amen.
When you was where?
In the club.
Oh, come on.
I wasn't born sanctified.
You weren't born sanctified?
No, I had a life too. But
hallelujah.
Somewhere down the line, grandmama, mama.
Come on.
Somebody was praying for me that night.
Yes.
Amen.
And so I know and I believe in praying for one for another.
Yes. So somebody was praying for you when you couldn't pray for yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Caught up in the world. Never had me. I couldn't even just call Jesus' name. The only thing I could do was just be involved in the world. But somebody else was praying.
So prayer will reach you wherever you are?
Reach you wherever
Amen.
You are.
Come and get you.
Yes, ma'am. It will come and get you. Just Amen. Like you said. Come and get you. You can't hide from prayer.
Amen. You can't
wow,
hide from
prayer. Wow, praise God. Mama's mm-hmm. prayer, grandma's prayer, sister's yes. prayer, mm-hmm. uncle's prayer.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody pray
somebody
for me.
Somebody
yes.
pray
yes.
for me.
Yes. Yeah. Amen.
And that's
true.
What I want somebody to know tonight, that somebody's praying for you.
Yes. Yes.
They got you on their mind. Amen.
Hallelujah.
They took the time
Amen.
Out
Thank you,
and prayed for you. Amen.
Glory
so you are not alone. You are not by yourself. Amen. I don't care what's going on in your life. God has got you. His hand is on your life.
Hallelujah.
And he's pulling you. You feel the Spirit of God pulling you? Amen. Amen. This surrender to God tonight.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We're getting ready to go to Rod Williams singing, He's Able. Come on. Amen. He's able.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all you could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in you. Don't give up on God.
won't give up on you. Ooh, don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. And he says, hallelujah. God bless you.
Wow, praise God. That's the anointed Rob Williams singing, Amen. God is able. And I just want to talk to somebody just a minute and let you know that God is able. I don't care what it is that you're dealing with tonight.
Hallelujah.
God is able. Don't give up on him. He's going to see you through this.
Yes.
Don't give up on
God.
He's going to see you through this.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. Somebody called in. We got two more praise reports to call in tonight. Mary wanted to thank God in advance for her 59th birthday next Wednesday. Happy birthday. Ooh, happy Amen. Birthday. It's good to be alive in the land of the living. And thanking God for every day, every minute, every second of our lives. Amen. Betty, God hear her lungs, her legs, and her body. She's thankful for prayer tonight. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Thank you for calling in and letting us know what God is doing in your body. Amen. Well, we're going back to this awesome, mighty men of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Minister Rob just finished singing, God is able.
Yes.
Is God able, Apostle?
God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask and think according to the power of God that works within us. There is absolutely nothing too hard for God. He's able.
He's able. He said he would do what now? Exceedingly?
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can even comprehend. Mm-hmm. We can't even comprehend in our finite minds what God is able to do if we walk by faith and we trust him.
Yes.
God can do all things.
Yes, yes he can. Yes, he can. Mm-hmm. And so we was talking about a few minutes ago before Rod was singing about how the prayer of intercession. We talked about that just briefly. But I want us to touch on that again, the prayer of intercession. Pastor James, you see me looking at you like.
Well, I mean, that's one of our jobs, you know, to stand in, you know, in prayer for, you know, family, Amen. Friends, and I mean, go to the throne of God for them in that situation where they can't all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they might be in a situation where they can't really reach, you know, and get a hold to God like we can. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But as pastors and as Christians, as people of God, you know, if we've been praying, we're in a place, you know, we can get in touch with God. And so that's our job, is to stay on that, you know, and always praying, you know, for the saints and praying for, you know, sinners and different one is our job to do that.
Because one thing about your church, your ministry, well, all of y'all have churches, outreach ministries.
Mm-hmm.
But your church, I know it's an outreach ministry, and you have people just walk in off the street, homeless, whatever. You know, how do you encourage them in their walk with God?
Well, I encourage them and let them know, first of all, that God loved them.
Mm-hmm.
And he see their situation.
Say that one more time. Somebody
he loved them. And that's what we always say when they come in like that, that, hey, God loves you, and we love you too. And so that's why it's called a place of hope. When you come here, we'll give you hope through the word of God.
Yes, and
what God is saying, you know. Yes. And from our lives, we know that there's hope in God. And so, and we teach them that, and we'll tell them that love, you know. We're just going to give you love and let you know that God hadn't forgotten about you.
Amen.
Your church is called a place of hope.
Yes.
You know, that's one thing I loved about the lineup for tonight. Yours is place of hope. Yours is bread from heaven.
Amen.
Praise God. Talk about the spiritual bread from heaven in prayer.
Well, the spiritual bread from heaven, John 15:51 said that I am the bread, the living bread, that if any man eat of me, he shall not hunger. And so we have on the back of some of our cards, stay hungry.
And stay hungry.
Yes, ma'am, stay hungry for the word of God. And so at the church, we try to set the atmosphere of love because it's bread from heaven family church.
Yes.
We try to teach you as a family how to grow in God, how to pray together as a family, how to feel the love of God when you come in, how the Holy Spirit just sets the atmosphere to allow you to just surrender to God, your Father, and be able to talk to him. Mm-hmm. And that way you can carry yourself where, you know, no matter what your position in life, you're able to release and talk to the Father.
There you go. There you go. You can be in corporate.
Anywhere.
Or you can be sleeping on the bridge.
Anywhere.
Yeah.
You can talk to your Father.
Yes.
And so I just invite you to come and just taste the bread of heaven.
My God.
He said, oh, taste
God.
And see how good the Lord is.
And Apostle, you open door.
Open
now,
door.
Now, when you think about open door, when God said in the realm, I'll open a door that no man can shut.
Amen.
Come on,
amen.
Can we go to God through that open door?
Oh, yes. There's always open access to amen. God
amen.
Through the open door. He said, behold, I set before you an open door, amen. And no man can shut it. And, you know, through prayer, God opens doors that no man can shut.
Amen.
There you go.
Amen. That's why you have to stay. You have to stay before God in prayer. Because God is able to do some things in the supernatural that people can't do in the natural.
There you go.
Amen. He'll open doors. He'll make ways. Mm-hmm. But you got to learn it as a believer to be persistent in prayer. Mm-hmm. You can't give up when you don't see things happen, things change the first day.
That's right.
Even a week, you know, you have to stay persistent and you have to stay in the presence of God and trust
amen.
God and believe God
amen.
That he's going to turn it around
amen.
In that prayer.
Yeah.
Amen.
And then one thing in Revelation talks about with John the Revelator said, I was in the spirit.
Yes.
On the Lord's day.
Yes.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God.
Yes.
Can prayer get you in the spirit? Pastor?
Yes, I have had dry runs. Anybody ever have a dry run?
What's a dry run?
When you don't feel like praying, and you just don't feel like
amen.
Praying.
I mean, we all have those.
And I have gone into the living room, shut the lights off, and I've gone in there, and I'll just start a prayer, a conversation with the Lord, and I humble myself because He doesn't care much for the arrogant and the proud.
Mm. Come on.
So when you humble yourself, and then all of a sudden I start feeling the fire of the Holy Spirit.
Mm. Ooh,
and then
Jesus.
I go from not knowing exactly how to pray to praying in the Spirit.
Come there you go.
Anointed in prayer.
Amen.
And then sometimes when he touches me, I'll just be silent in a room because the Spirit is doing his work in me and in others. And we must always pray. In Thessalonians, it says not...
Amen.
To continue in prayer all the time.
Yes.
Never cease to pray.
That's right.
And pray for the lost and pray for your leaders and pray for your churches.
Mm-hmm.
We need to pray for our churches, folks.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
We need to pray instead of condemning our churches. We need to pray for a great revival and outpouring. I'm praying, Lord,
hallelujah.
Sweep through the entire
nation.
Yes.
Let the world be aware of who you are, Father,
and
bring down those principalities and those strongholds through prayer.
Yes.
Prayer can destroy everything that's dammed up in your life.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Prayer can destroy the works of the enemy.
That's demolish. Demolish the work of the enemy.
Demolish it.
Demolish the strongholds.
Yeah.
Amen. That's what prayer does. It tear down the strategies of the enemy. Let me tell you that the Holy Ghost is more wiser than the devil.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
The Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I mean, his wisdom, his understanding supersedes that of the devil. So when we get in the presence of God in prayer, God will our wisdom and our understanding will supersede the strategies of the enemy. That's why the enemy tried to keep the believer out of prayer. He tried to keep us out of the presence of God because he know when we come out of the presence of God, we're going to be able to whip his behind.
Mm-hmm.
So he don't want us to pray.
Right.
Because when a praying church is a powerful church.
There you go.
And praying people are powerful people.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If my people, which are called by my name, as my brother said, would humble themselves and pray and seek my face, right? Mm. God will give us power.
That's
God will help us to fulfill the plan of God for our life.
Can I bounce off of that?
Yes, sir.
Well, prayer releases healing.
Yes.
And it restores the land.
Wow.
And, you know, we live off the land. And if the land that you're on has God's blessing, it's going to produce a harvest. So if my people who are called by my name, we got a name we're called by. We're not called by anybody else's name.
Amen.
You know, I don't go around telling people I'm Pentecostal or Plenty Hostile. I tell people that I'm a born-again child of God and that
Plenty
my name
hostile.
Is written in the Lamb's Book
Come
of
on.
Life. And I belong to
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ. So we belong to Christ and, you know, that name. We've been called by his name.
Yes.
And he said if we humble ourselves and pray,
Boy,
there's power in prayer. And somebody's watching tonight that may feel like God has abandoned them. They may feel like they're all alone in this. Just start praying and release the power of God's Holy Spirit in your life.
Amen.
You fire
Amen.
Me up, man.
Praise God. Praise God. Listen, somebody called in with a praise. Miscellaneous report said a lady called in and said she liked what Pastor Samuel said about prayer. She had been dealing with anxiety. She said, Pastor Samuel said, taking authority over it. Amen. To God be all the glory. To God be all the glory. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, I'll tell you what, the first hour went by pretty fast, didn't it? Amen. And then we've been having an awesome time in God. And I know that we're going to continue to have an awesome time on the second hour. But I'm going to tell you what, y'all are some mighty men of God. Y'all, amen. Y'all, you know, one thing, too, I want to say that in order for a church to get on his feet, it's first got to get on his knees. In order for a church to get on his feet, it's first got to get on his knees. Yes. Amen. Amen. Praise God.
I'm very big on prayer. We have a Monday night prayer, and that's one of the things when I opened the church that God, was strongly, told me, to keep that prayer night, that Monday night prayer, because it's very important. Mm-hmm. Very important too.
So y'all have prayer on Monday night.
On Monday night.
Yeah.
We have prayer.
So what night y'all have prayer on?
Our prayer is at Tuesday night at 6:00.
Amen. Praise God. And yours, when is yours?
Tuesday night.
When is yours?
Mine is at my house 24/7. 7 days a week. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise God. We're closing out for the first hour. Come back for the second hour. Oh my God. God is really moving tonight. Amen. Call somebody. We love you. Amen. Amen.